Have you ever imagined robots so small that you could barely see them with the naked eye? Now imagine those same robots being able to communicate with each other, share tasks, and move around in water as if they were tiny living creatures. It sounds like science fiction, but researchers at Chemnitz University of Technology in Germany have turned this into reality. A group of scientists working at the Research Center for Materials, Architectures, and Integration of Nanomembranes, better known as MAINE, has created a new type of microrobot they call Smartlets. These Smartlets are not just miniature robots. They are a leap forward in the way tiny machines can behave because they can respond to their environment, talk to each other through light signals, and even coordinate movements like a team. This breakthrough could one day open the door to robotic systems that behave almost like small colonies of digital organisms. Think of them like robot ants, only much smaller and swimming around in water. A Smartlet is a very tiny robot, only about 1 millimeter in size. To put that in perspective, a grain of rice is around 6 millimeters long. These robots are about 6 times smaller than that. Yet inside this tiny body, each Smartlet is packed with everything it needs to function on its own. They come with built-in electronics, sensors, actuators, and even their own energy systems. Each one can receive and send out optical signals, meaning they can communicate using light. They can also respond to changes in their surroundings by moving. And perhaps most importantly, they can exchange information with other nearby Smartlets, allowing them to act like a group instead of just single robots working alone. Before Smartlets, many microrobots were designed with limited abilities. To make them work, researchers had to use large external devices to control them, often relying on magnets or wireless signals from bulky setups outside the water. That meant the robots themselves couldn't do much without outside help. Smartlets, however, are different. They don't need external control systems because they carry everything inside their small bodies. They are powered by tiny solar cells, which act like their personal energy source. They have microchips inside that work like little brains, and they communicate using special micro-LEDs and photodiodes that allow them to send and receive light messages. This independence makes them far more capable than earlier designs. It means scientists can imagine real-world uses for them, outside the lab, without needing huge support systems to make them function. You might be wondering how such a small robot can carry all these parts. The answer lies in a clever design inspired by origami, the Japanese art of paper folding. The researchers built the robots using special layered materials that can fold and roll up by themselves. When flat, the design looks like a tiny electronic sheet. But once activated, it folds into a three-dimensional cube shape with hollow spaces inside. This folding system creates enough surface area for the robot to hold solar cells, communication devices, and control logic while keeping the body tiny and compact. This origami-inspired design also makes the robots flexible and adaptable. They can carry parts both inside and outside their cube-shaped structure. It's a smart way to solve the problem of fitting so many functions into such a small body. One of the most fascinating features of these microrobots is the way they move. When placed in water, the Smartlets can rise and sink by using tiny bubble engines. These engines fill the hollow space inside the cube with gas, which makes the robot float upward. When the bubbles are released, the robot sinks back down. This ability to move up and down by controlling buoyancy is simple but effective. It allows the Smartlets to navigate their environment without the need for complicated propellers or motors. It also means they can move in a way that feels natural in liquid surroundings. The communication system of Smartlets is another big leap forward. Instead of using radio waves, magnets, or external cameras, these robots talk to each other using light. Each Smartlet has small LEDs and photodiodes that allow it to flash signals and read signals coming from others. For example, one Smartlet can send out a pulse of light carrying instructions. A nearby Smartlet receives the light, decodes the message with its tiny processor, and then reacts by moving or sending a message of its own. This creates a wireless loop of communication between the robots. Because the communication happens inside each robot, There's no need for large antennas or external equipment. This gives the group of Smartlets more freedom to interact on their own. The beauty of Smartlets lies not just in what each robot can do individually, but in how they work together. When one robot receives a signal, it can trigger a chain reaction, making the whole group respond in a synchronized way. This ability to coordinate makes the robots behave almost like living organisms that share information to survive and thrive together. In nature, we see this type of coordination in groups of ants, flocks of birds, or schools of fish. With Smartlets, scientists are bringing that same principle into the world of microrobotics. The Smartlets make use of tiny silicon chiplets called lablets. These were developed in an earlier project led by Professor John McCaskill, one of the researchers involved in this study. The lablets are attached to the robot's origami films using soft bonding techniques. These chiplets are important because they allow the robots to have decentralized control. Instead of relying on one central system to manage everything, each robot can process information on its own. This decentralized setup is what makes it possible for the robots to behave like a collective. While these Smartlets are still being tested in laboratories, the possibilities for their future use are exciting. Because they are untethered, small, and biocompatible, they could be used in medical fields for tasks like minimally invasive diagnostics. Imagine a swarm of Smartlets moving inside the body to deliver medicine or monitor tissues in hard-to-reach areas. In environmental science, they could be used to monitor water quality. Since they can sense their surroundings and react to changes, they could act as tiny inspectors, swimming through rivers or reservoirs and checking for pollution. They could also play a role in soft robotics, where flexible machines are needed, or in distributed sensing networks, where groups of devices work together to gather information across large areas. The researchers see Smartlets as the beginning of something much bigger. They imagine that, over time, these robots could evolve into dynamic systems that function like colonies of digital organisms. In biology, animals like siphonophores form colonies where each member plays a different role. One might focus on movement, another on sensing, and another on communication. Smartlets could one day be designed in the same way. One type of Smartlet might be better at moving, another at sensing, and another at sending signals. Together, they could form an artificial organism, each part supporting the others in a living system of machines. This vision goes far beyond simple robotics. It points toward a future where machines are no longer just tools, but act more like partners in natural systems. The work done at Chemnitz University is not just about building a new kind of robot. It's about setting the stage for a new era in robotics. By proving that microrobots can communicate, work together, and operate independently, the researchers are solving problems that have held back this field for years. The dream is that one day, these robots could self-organize in real-world settings, whether that's inside a droplet of water, inside the human body, or even inside artificial ecosystems designed for research. If that happens, we might be witnessing the early steps of a revolution where machines behave like living organisms, tiny, collaborative, and capable of creating systems greater than the sum of their parts. The creation of Smartlets is more than just a clever invention. It's a step toward a future where machines, no matter how small, can think, communicate, and cooperate. The idea of tiny robots swimming in water, flashing light signals to each other, and forming colonies might sound like something out of a futuristic movie. But thanks to the work of researchers at Chemnitz University, it's becoming real. As these microrobots continue to evolve, they could one day play a role in medicine, environmental monitoring, and even artificial ecosystems. For now, they remind us how powerful science can be when creativity meets technology. We are only at the beginning of this story, but it's a story worth watching closely. Because sometimes the smallest inventions can lead to the biggest changes in our world.